Hey guys, you're Worker Bros, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Liverpool promo. Where last off, I've picked up wins in the league over Aston Villa and in the Merseyside Derby over Everton. We're in the last episode, we also saw the debut of 70 million in man Dele Alli. And you're probably saying to yourself, this is the... And you'd be correct, this is indeed the fourth round of the FA Cup. As you can see, I got Arsenal. So, tough draw.
Well, it's
not compared to getting Cambridge United in the last
FA Cup. As we must rightly call it now.
You know.
And it's a very...
If I didn't get Arsenal at this point, I might get them later, so...
There's always a buzz.
You know, this could be looked at as, you know, getting them out of the way.
There's a buzz around this ground, too. So Arsenal against...
Only a very strong second there. You know, season after season. Up for the...
Often with trophies at stake, too.
Yep, and we've got two good sides here. Led by...
You have a few new players to introduce. This will
battle at times.
Sign off.
This is the Arsenal lineup.
Cameron
Goldian Oblak. Laurent Koscielny starts. He was man of the match
last episode.
And today it's just
it
the one
the,
strike in the side.
In the moment of the transfer of the January transfer window. And I wanna talk a bit about the second leg, the seventh of the EFL Cup. I simulated the game against Watford. I beat them 5-0 at Anfield. Moya got a hat trick and two goals for a new signing. Well, into
the attacking third.
Later.
Well, they're going to start.
I don't
from
think
the
I have him on the bench.
Pass to the keeper.
I might though. But I got the depth I was looking for. I didn't recall. Well, Joe Gomez, I decided against it in the end.
Caught too square to his man there, Paul. Gets his foot in there.
We'll see what happens in the summer. I may have my mind on what's going to happen.
Giving the ball away now.
Although I have a vision of what's going to happen. And, you know,
really trying to use
some
the pull
stones
the
may have to be turned
some
and
progress.
Some players may need to be moved.
Here's
I'm not talking words. Talking permanent dealings.
And he could get away here. It's good play until they got that challenge in. A lot of defenders
Anywho.
Between them and the goal, but they've still got the ball. He can put them in front. Chance taken. Goal. They're in front.
Grujic makes it 1-0, 22nd minute. About the same time I scored the first goal against Cambridge.
The way he's hit this one. He flew off his boot to beat the keeper. Different angle on it here.
It's an odd coincidence. Anywho.
That has opened the scoring. 1-0 here.
What was I saying? Yeah, I'm gonna reassess
the Awara
in the summer window.
There's some potential in this
one way or another. I'm gonna probably have
terrific tackle.
A few players, you know, who just like, cutting it and growing fast enough, or
Alex
just don't fit the position. And I need them to fill.
Shot on! That had equaliser written all over it.
Well, when you see him this season, he's finished harder chances than that. I don't think he can believe
it. Which aren't good enough. Some details that need to be ironed out.
Attacking well here.
Yeah, I got the...
the break. Sturridge!
I signed three new players who I needed.
To the good, of course.
None who are playing today. Two of them I know are on the bench. I don't think the third one is though. So maybe I'll
absolutely no trouble for the goalkeeper here.
Then
save that shot from distance.
I think you met one of them in the last episode. You might have actually
got the tackle in.
Is that?
And Arsenal have possession. They've won
I'm
it.
I sort of think now that I see
Danny Welbeck.
Before I stop worrying, I might just
giving the opposition a problem with their interpassing.
I think actually
Santi Cazorla.
I don't remember. I might have already actually introduced you guys to the right back in the center.
Got a chance in this
my signings are have were a right back, back to rotate with a Calabria for the second team.
Move has broken down.
Whom I ended up signing, who ball, I think is Dani Alves' read.
Get your rewards, but not
and
today for
nothing.
They do say possession 9/10 of the law, but it's not been enough to get them in front so far.
Looking at, I can't see anything Calabria. That would contradict that because I can't. And find him, which would indicate to me that he did indeed retire. And I know for a fact that he was still at Juventus.
Sturridge.
Is when I was looking at center midfielders and the somewhere when I was trying to get out. Sorry, Renato Sanchez!
And that's half time. Signaled by the referee. 1-0 the half time score.
Oh my god, how did that not go in?
Well, the player that we're featuring.
Arsenal are lucky, E man.
Well, he played really well, didn't he? And he got himself.
Oh my god.
He'll be pleased with that first 45 minutes.
Trent Alexander Arnold, who's on. Who scored two goals in Friday's episode. Almost made it three in this recording session. But the ball was clear off the line. I think it was by Kieran Gibbs after it hit the post on the earth opposite side of where he was standing.
Here we go
initially.
For the second half of this Emirates.
When the score line disappeared, I wasn't even paying attention to the time. When the score disappeared, I thought it crossed the line, and goal line technology had said to the referee, yo, it's a goal across the line. But, it must have been, like, narrow. Anyway, I looked at you when I was looking for, when I was looking at, you know, I was almost certainly getting Renato Sanchez. He was my number one target. But I did look at other options. I wanted to look at Benega from Inter Milan. So I went to
the direction of what's coming
sorry,
up on EA
and accidentally he reset the search
Arsenal
thing. So it brought up all the players. I said, you know what? And let me have a look for Buffon's regen, because I knew Buffon had retired the season before.
Here's Emre Moore. Tackle here.
Moving after forward. After the second season. So.
Well, they passed their way up into a position here.
As I was scrolling over, I passed defenders.
Kept it out.
And normally, one of the big players would be there, and I'd say.
Next game.
Let me check, see if any, you know, say, cheap Chiellini or
well, time is
or someone like that is
time
retiring. As I was looking through, I saw Dani Alves chilling in there with Juventus. This is bad right next to him.
The shot's on! Terrific stop! It's a corner coming.
I didn't go into.
No nonsense defending from him. Shot on! That's a fine strike, but not quite what he was looking for.
He must have retired at the end of the season too soon. As Buffon did. I didn't even think of Dani Alves because he was not as old as some of the other players. As I checked,
Hector Berry.
In fact, he was. I think. I think Zalba, he's only like 34, 35. Well, I mean,
take over possession again.
Xabi Alonso is retiring at the end of the season. He's 35, but, you know. Damn.
Here's a chance to attack.
I can see. I think he might go as long as he can. He's one of those players who
put the ball into touch.
Or if he has a really successful season, like if Juventus win the championship,
strong challenge.
He might retire then.
20 minutes now remaining.
Well, he makes that transition happen quickly.
But no, he decided to hang him up. And granted, yeah, it's season two is
well bet.
Well,
he's read that, hasn't he? And made the interception, made it look easy.
After next season, but you know, that would indicate that he is retiring at the end of next season.
Here's the shot.
But I don't think it's gonna happen at all.
By two now.
Because Diawara makes it 2-0.
Good value for this advantage at the moment.
Sneaking that in, somehow.
Enough touch.
Yeah, he's annoyed with himself, isn't he?
Oh.
Having got a touch on it.
I thought All Black
was
close to getting a hand on it. It kind of like over his hand. It almost looked like he had lowered his hand.
Margin here to 2-0.
I want to talk about my goalkeeper,
Alex Oxlade-Chamberlain.
A situation that arose on deadline.
Well, I wouldn't be surprised to see the opposition manager put another centre half on here to try and cope
Harris.
With this aerial bombardment that's about to come. I think
one back very quickly. Really trying to use the full width of the pitch here to make some progress.
We've got
talk about
that
minutes
in a second.
The
I can't.
Promising build
like maybe he will. Maybe he'll come out. Oh, and
given the ball away.
He at some point doing. Nah, when they're down, I didn't say, yeah, next season's gonna
stop,
be his last.
Stop.
I just can't see it, you know.
Towards Oxlade-Chamberlain on the attack here. Well, he's caught offside, trying to get in behind.
He moved up.
Come a bit earlier.
Yeah, if he was going to retire
his teammate, he did want that pass
so early. I mean, what was the point of moving on from Barcelona? Yeah, very successful career there. Where he could have easily, happily retired.
Good forward play from them. Not a
very
great
early, you know.
Pretty easy to
after ending his stint to Barcelona.
And that's a
yeah.
Confirmed for Liverpool.
I mean, maybe I'm thinking too much into this. We're just gonna have a quick look at this. What's this?
In the corner. He's had a go here.
Oh my goodness!
Well, that technology that's come into play here—it stops the players chasing the referee.
Oh, see, no goal.
No, they trust the technology. It's no goal.
Yeah, and I think it helps everybody inside the stadium as well. Stops.
Right on the line as Kieran Gibbs. Whacked it away. But in the end, I did get a second goal, so his clearance mattered very little in the end.
The Football Association Challenge Cup.
Brighton, after beating Chelsea, lost to Chesterfield.
2. Aston Villa 2.
I can't be the only one who knows that.
Cardiff City 0. Manchester United 1.
Unfreaking believable. This is the new centre back. He's Albanian. I think I introduced him in last episode.
1. Everton 1.
As you can see, Karras is still here, but I do want to talk about something that happened concerning him on deadline day.
Sheffield Wednesday 2.
That's the Daniel was region.
Stoke City 3. Shrewsbury Town.
Anderson does.
Swansea City 0, Manchester City
1,
Tottenham Hotspur 2,
Bessias
0.
Gonna have to learn how to pronounce his name properly.
2.
And the third signing is he's probably under wingers. Here, Mitchell van Bergen. You're probably saying, he doesn't look that anything that special. Well, he's a... Hey, yo. I signed him from Vitesse for $6 million. You know, the game says I overpaid, which maybe I did. And to be honest, I was kind of, you know, I did kind of rush to get him in. I could have probably gotten him for like $4 or $5 million. And probably didn't need to pay $6 million. But, you know, I got my man in the end. And, you know, Mitchell gives the perfect depth to the squad. Because now I don't have to play Alexander-Arnold every single game. When I play the second team, I can rotate, you know. And I like to rotate that second team so everyone gets a fair shot, you know. And so we can deal with injuries, which is another thing that happened. And after the window ended, and this is my own fault. It's my own fault. Well, because I was the one saying, oh, I had been very lucky with injuries. Luckily, it's not someone, too big. So, you know, the blow isn't you know, a knockout. It's stuns, but you know, it's not gonna end a fight. You know, it's that kind of punch. And then, whoops. The player in question, no, it's not Sidic, it's the other guy, it's your Turkish sermon. Where is he? Yigit. Here, Yigit. He is out for 4 months. He's pretty much done for the season. And a real bummer because I see if I can get him up a good rings, I definitely could see him as a star or player in a few seasons. So, you know, really bummer situation for you get to suffer a really bad injury that pretty much ends his season. Like 4 months. You know, we're just into February, so he's gonna be gone all the way until May, which is like right at the end of the season. That's past all sorts of games that he would have played. Like, he might come back late April at the earliest, but even at then, all those games are gonna be gone. So I think he has played his last minutes for the season, which must really devastate him. I can't imagine it's not something that he would have been too happy with, obviously. But yeah, 4 months. Luckily, it isn't a bigger player, but you know, it's still an injury, and it's still a player. I was gonna, you know, play. He was gonna play a good few of the games over the season, and now he's just, you know, his playing time will go to somebody else. Well, I mean, someone else's benefit, but you know.
Hi there, everybody. Thank you for joining us.
That's lost
in Southampton today.
Game time, and you know,
which Alan Smith will describe along with me.
I'm assuming he's still gonna get paid, but you know.
Southampton in action today, play Liverpool.
He's not going to get any goals or clean sheets or any of that stuff. So no bonuses or any of that stuff. So that's a bit of lost income.
Liverpool come here on a very
and,
away
yeah, so
in the league.
Bad luck for Higgett.
In the last 10 games. And shoots!
Gone for goal.
He goes down with that form on injury. Now, to discuss what happened with Loris Karius. On deadline day, I'm assuming true deadline day, this was just normal deadline day. I wasn't planning to do any business. Then I got an email. I'm like, okay, this is probably just an email for a player I completely forgot to disallow offers for. Let's go in, reject the future offer. I see it was for Karius. And if you guys saw the last episode, you know I was really angry with Karius at that point.
Ruiz.
Well, these are recorded directly one after another.
For West Ham United.
Hours at most.
A great break down the right.
Gap.
He made up ground to arrive on the edge of the area in time to steer the pullback past the keeper. 7 minutes played.
Hour two. You know, just to work on our stuff in between. So the
Jordy Classy. It's Matt Target. A lot of defenders between them and the goal, but they still got the ball. Well, this attack has got a bit of menace to it. Origi.
As I was
trying to thread it through here, he might be through.
Even after her
scores here,
taking a bit of a break.
It's got an air of grace.
I was looking at the offer and thinking,
he is just flat-footed.
If I can get a certain amount, I might actually just do it. Because Dele Alli scores
this goal.
His second goal since joining in the club. Or he matched his goals his time with Spurs during the season. In terms of goals this season, he's he doubled his tally in three games at Liverpool.
Now Target. White Hart Lane today in front of our man.
Anyway,
it's a goal for Aston Villa.
So
17 minutes played.
I'm looking at the offer. I'm thinking, okay, I'm gonna put this amount in. Initially, my offer, I wanted 87 million.
A bit heavy with the first touch.
I was like,
throw in here.
It's gonna be really hard to replace him, so whoever I get in will have to be quick, instant.
On the attack here. Patience is the name of the game at the moment.
They rejected that. I went back in with 77 million, trying to, appease to them more. I was kind of hoping they wouldn't accept it because at that point, there were 3 hours left. So, even if they had accepted it, which they did, actually, they accepted to pay 77 million. So, Lafont would currently be in goal if there was more time. If they had an extra hour, I think the deal would have gone through. But, I would have been left with, not no goalkeeper, because Lafont is a very good goalkeeper. But I would have
chance that was for him.
Been
the glaring miss.
Without Karius, which
was a goal for Chelsea. We were hearing from Alan McAnally earlier, and that's the first goal of the game. It's 1-0.
And as I ended the transfer window, this was
Alan Ruiz. Return pass.
Yeah,
good friend Alan McAnally is
watching the training.
White Hart Lane, Alan.
And, it happened.
34 minutes, please. 1-1.
From time to time.
News again from Alan McAnally.
As that was happening, I was like,
he's coming forward.
Wow.
With some danger.
So instantly, I talked to a friend on Twitter via DMs, and he's like, so they accepted the pay 77? And I was like, yeah.
Quick.
If they had an extra hour, they would have got him. I would have had no carrots.
The Premier League fixture for Southampton, they'll be hosting Arsenal.
Yeah, I've had a lot of supporters.
And he said, on one hand, he could understand that I was frustrated. I sent him the video. Oh.
Saw the goal and went for it.
And he looked at the clip, and he's a Liverpool fan too, so he was fuming, and he said the exact same thing that I did. That was the same kind of bullshit that Karius and Mignolet are always pulling in real life. They're always making huge mistakes from corners. As Dele Alli scores his second goal of the game. Incidentally, he has more goals this season in 3 games for Liverpool. And he has up until the point I signed him in the games he played for Spurs. So, you know, make that what you will.
At 2-0.
And I also talked to about Dele Alli's number. Or about the R numbers.
Austin.
Moving forward. I'll tell you guys more about that. Now they're here. So, you know, he said on one hand it's a one-time deal and Karius, you know, maybe he won't do it again. 4 minutes. But he says the decision ultimately is mine, that if in summer, if Bayern were to come back in and try to get Karius again, if 77 million sounds tempting, you know, I'll have a lot more time to acquire a new goalkeeper. If I want a new goalkeeper, I mean, I could just play Lafon. I don't have to rotate my goalkeepers on the second team. I could always just play Efe or as the second team goalkeeper all the time and just keep Lafon as the main goalkeeper. That's something I could do as well. Lafont is only 80 rated, but, you know,
probably the better side.
He will grow a lot quicker before the interval bite in goal, especially if you get rid of the sheets. So it's a decision I'm gonna have to make. What I said to my friend, and I said, chances are underway. Bayern might not come back in for him. If they do, I'll consider it. But, you know, this will be summer. There's a lot of games between now and then. Karius, you know, maybe Karius will not do it again. Maybe, you know, it's a one-off. And
now the shot! Goalkeeper hangs on.
But I did. I don't know if this was just
playing Crystal Palace
because I was still a bit frustrated about it, and maybe it was spur of the moment. But I did. I remember vividly saying, if Karius does it again, I would drop him instantly, sub him off in whatever game it is, unless it's right at the end, like it was against Everton, and Lafont would play the rest of the game. And Karius will be listed
and now we'll have a
for
kick.
Sale. He would be gone. Like, I'm always fuming when that happens in real life.
Now they've got a chance in this part of the
game. I know the game is. I know EA are trying to make the game more realistic. Please don't let the goalkeepers for Liverpool be as stupid as they are in real life.
In for the hat trick, you know? But he's still waiting for it.
Let the AI have some bit of common sense. I didn't tell Karius to come out and try to punch the ball. He did, and it fucking cost him a clean sheet. I didn't do that.
And with the team,
the game did that. And that's not me. He pointing fingers. I'm not trying to blame the game. I'm just saying Karius made a huge mistake and he needs to just look himself.
It's a third goal,
you know,
Crystal Palace.
I imagine in real life he probably blames himself whenever he makes a stupid error and manually too. I imagine they do if they have a brain. But then again, if they had a brain, they wouldn't be in that situation to begin with. Anyway,
patience is
the name. To the numbers discussion.
That's not a good cross at all, and easy to defend.
My friend, and said, you know, he thinks Dele Alli should stay number 7. And that, you know, Renato Sanchez being number 20 is perfectly fine.
The shot's up!
He doesn't see anything wrong with it. And I was like,
I have to say, the game's passing him by in midfield today.
I wasn't too sure, but, you know, him scoring both goals in this game, as he's playing in a more defensive role, which is, you know, it's really good from someone who's...
This could be a chance.
Really, he's playing out of position, but, you know, you wouldn't think it.
Well, the defenders could only
correct position and scored 2 goals. As yet, there's been no other goals. But yeah, I think he's gonna keep the number 7 for now. I don't see any reason to take it off him. And my friend,
with some danger, Alan Ruiz.
He helped with that.
Looked very good indeed, but the move has broken down.
So. Those are two.
Bit of pressure on the player, that's why it's gone out. It's a change that's got to be made now to step up the attack.
Two things that were level terms. They bring making warm in my head.
This team has had its back to the wall for a while now, and they do need a bit more momentum.
Thoughts.
Here's Gardosh.
They were running fucking mad and causing utter fucking chaos up there. You know, so it was good to, you know, get really someone else's opinion
for a throw.
Come up with some sort of plan. And, you know, it's good to have a plan. We briefly discussed possible
Jose Fox
announced, but, you know, we didn't, you know, discuss who should and who shouldn't be sold or kept.
Official has indicated there will be a minimum
tackle here.
3 minutes of added time.
So, you know,
it's Ward-Prowse.
That's the thing. That we talked about and. We talked
City,
about it.
1. Manchester United 0. Chelsea 1. Southampton 0. Liverpool 2.
And,
Sunderland 2.
Yeah.
Leicester City 0.
Dele Alli's 2 goals are enough to
Aston
see off
1.
Southampton
United,
and their
Crystal
bad form.
And
is
let's
really,
take a look
really
the league table.
You're looking bad.
At the top of the table remain
you can
Liverpool.
See how much it's affecting
points.
Them. In Arsenal second, have really turned it around from the last time I looked at the table, haven't they?
Points.
They're up to 10.
In third, moving down are Manchester City with
21
points. With a game
London
in
club in most
the
danger
the
now is West Ham United, who
are
only
with
a place
points.
Above the drops.
In fifth and falling are Manchester United.
Gap
with
to Holland,
behind
Southampton.
On goal difference. In sixth, Chelsea with 38 points.
And up top, Crystal Palace are back into second place.
35 points, with a game in hand.
No, this is not me repeating myself from last season. They are back up into second place. Manchester City, who have to still play,
with a game in hand on the team above.
So it might only be temporary.
Second bottom, Southampton with 19 points, but only behind on goal difference.
We're back into the top four.
Hull City with
19
points.
They've gotten
bottom,
back on
West
the
United with 21
track.
Points. Fifth yeah. bottom, moving down,
on
Swansea
all,
City with 22 points.
Looking comfortable for me. You know, 28 points clear. That gap will be cut by Manchester City when they play. If they win, you know, they might lose. We'll see. Hang on. They didn't play. Okay. I guess that's a game in hand then. Going into the next episode, it's the gap is 28 points after. 23 games, which leaves us with 15. So, still a good bit to go. Oh, it's very tight below me, but in the title race, it seems to be a one-horse race. Because no one seems to care. And Crystal Palace, he'd be the closest team to me right now. But you can see who's next in line for slaughter in the next episode. Until the next episode, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe if you're new. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.